I know it all right, Mr. Dobson, and I'll be watching. No worries.
Okay. Now, here we are. That's a tuberous begonia.
Oh, jeez. Will it get any better?
That's its name, Cass. They're very good indoor plants. I thought you might like it for your dorm.
Oh, jeez, Mr. Dobson, my own little plant. That'll be great.
I'll just go get a pot for it. Won't be long.
Yeah, okay.
That's supposed to be.
Well, why don't you find out who put it here and ask them?
Why should I do that?
Listen, you were supposed to be looking after me.
Well, that was before you set me up.
Well, what the hell are you talking about?
Went to see Meryl King today. A couple of heavies arrived for the welcoming party.
So speak to Meryl about it.
That's a bit difficult. Your friends shot her dead. Afternoon papers are full of it.
My friends? I had nothing to do with that. You've got to believe me.
Oh, come on, pull the other one. Stevens, you use Meryl King just like you use everybody else.
That is not true.
Truth! She wouldn't know if it fell on you. You just fight your own battles from now on.
Righto, ladies, that's it for today. Move off, will you? Come on.
Mark, it won't be long, Mrs. Right. Burrows. Ah, that should do it, Cass. Now, I found this old bag in the shed. If we slip it in there, you shouldn't get into a strife dropping dirt everywhere on the way in.
Yeah, good idea.
Mr. Dobson, can I have a word with you?
Oh. Excuse me, Mr. Dobson, we forgot the fork.
Oh, stick it in the flower bed. I'll put it away later.
Find somewhere really nice to keep this, eh?
Well, just so it gets plenty of light and give it a good soaking about once a week.
Oh, shouldn't I water it every day?
No, no, too much will rot the roots.
Oh, rats. Hey, look, I'll give you the bag back later, eh?
Chuck it in the rubbish. I think it's had its day. Yeah. Come on, you better get cleaned up for dinner or you'll be late.
And as Stanley retires the day before the trip and I won't be able to go, I'm looking for volunteers to accompany the women.
Well, I'd be happy to go if you could reorganise the rosters.
Yeah, I'll go, Governor. Always was a sucker for bus rides.
Thanks, Rick. And Meg. I'm sure it won't be difficult to change the rosters. Well, thank you for coming. I won't keep you any longer. Oh, Meg, let the women know, would you?
Yes, of course.
Could I see you for a moment, Colleen? I'd like you to volunteer as well. Two officers isn't enough.
I've already made my opinion of the trip quite clear.
Yeah, I know. I'm aware of that. But I won't be able to go, and I'd prefer senior officers to accompany them.
Well, perhaps Ferguson will be back by then.
She might, but we can't count on it. In any case, I would prefer you to be in charge.
Mrs. Reynolds, the only way I will go on that trip is if I am ordered to.
Very well. It's an order.
I'm sorry, Jill.
She's trying to get into the glee club. She's got Buckley's. She sings like a frog. They won't let you in either.
I'll take $5, they do.
They hate your guts.
Maybe. When they realise I'm just a poor, misunderstood kid, they'll be tripping over themselves to help me.
I hope you don't have to keep up the act for too long. Your halo might slip and strangle you.
You better hope it doesn't. You pinned your hopes on getting away with me.
May I have your attention, please, ladies? I have an announcement for the Glee Club. The trip is on.
Hey!
about Mara, is it true?
Yes, it is. Doesn't take long for news to travel, does it?
No, it certainly doesn't. When can I see her?
Tomorrow. She's pretty down, Judy. She'll need a lot of support.
Don't worry, Mrs. Mara. She'll get plenty of that.
Oh, fancy getting to have this dump for a whole day.
Yeah, geez, Mr. Dobson will be pleased.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, what about Reb?
You really want her to come on the trip, don't you?
Yeah. Well, you know what I reckon. Anybody who's trying ought to be given a go.
Well, if the department felt that, we'd all be out of here. Okay, Cass. Hey, Reb. Come here.
Geez, look at her. Don't reckon the saintly look suits her.
We've talked it over. You can join the club. You got Cass to thank for that.
Thanks, Cass. I know I don't deserve it.
You certainly don't. And you better walk the straight line, otherwise you'll be having honey and feathers on a regular basis.
Fair enough.
Ah, good on you, Reb. Oh, Jesus, it's gonna be fun!
Got the shakes. Practice over. Nah, just nicked off to the loo. Listen, you better start paying out on those gambling debts, or they're gonna get really tough.
Well, they can whistle for it. Scum like that doesn't frighten me.
Oh, yeah? Well, if you're so smart, how come you didn't crack it for the singing trip? I'm going.
Well, I got problems of my own. And I can think of better ways of spending a day other than with a bunch of morons.
Yeah? Well, you're the muck. This is going to be my big break. All the way out.
You got it set up?
Yeah. Real easy, too. Just had a chat to good old Uncle Kev. Now who's the clever one?
Judging by your last attempt, not you. You see, when I break out, I go in style. And I won't be coming back.
Hey, do you reckon we could get a hamburger when we get out?
I really don't know.
How about a little snort?
Come on, let's take this seriously. What Mrs. Morris tells me, the governor's really stuck her neck out so you can have this trip, so don't forget you owe her a big one.
Yeah, don't you worry, Mr. Dobson, not going to be no funny business. We're just going to enjoy ourselves and sing real good.
Lovely. Let's get on with the practice.
Oh, hang on. Can we watch the news? Because Camilla might be on.
Oh, yeah.
All right, Mitchell.
Oh, good one.
Everything all right, Bryant?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine, Mr. Dobson.
You look like you lost a pound and found a penny.
Just a friend of mine's been charged with murdering her husband.
Oh, that's rough. Still, look at it this way. At least she's got a friend on the inside.
She's got more than one friend. She's the woman that ran the PRG for years.
I understand how you feel. Keep your chin up.
Hey, fill up, everyone. Here she is.
Miss Wells, seen here leaving the prison, refused to be interviewed, but said she would be writing a series of newspaper articles about her stay at Wentworth. A statement issued by the Department of Social Welfare said Miss Wells had been released due to overcrowding at the prison. The talkback radio star did not serve her full 14-day sentence.
Oh, can't wait to see the papers.
You know why, they'd probably be censored anyway.
Righto, let's get back to it.
Yeah. Now, come on, Rev, you come and stand over here. I'll help you.
Oh, God, you might do better to stand with her mouth open.
Now, that's enough, Mitchell. Right, let's have the finale again, eh?
Finale, okay.
With a bop here and a bop there, here, bop there, bop everywhere, bop, bop, oh, here, oh, there, here, oh, there, everywhere.
Oh, Mrs. Powell, I'm sorry.
All right, that's it, Parker. You're on a charge, so you can forget about the trip.
Oh, that's not fair. It was an accident. I saw.
Shut your mouth or you won't go either.
But, Mrs. Powell, we need Cass for the animal noises.
Well, I'm sure there's a lot of you in here who can do those.
Well, that bloody does it. If Cass is not going, neither am I.
Well, I don't think any of us should go. We should tell the Estedford people that we'll use this as a protest against unfair treatment.
Yeah, good one. Don't you worry, Cass. We'll make them pay.
Well, look, will you all just shut up? Now, no one's given up on this trip because of me. Mr. Dobson's put in too much hard work for you to all let him down now. I'll teach Reb how to do the animal noises.
Cass, you can't...
She's better left on her own for a while. The best thing we can do for Cass is to get on with the practice. Come on now.
Oh.
Can you spare me a few minutes, Mrs. Powell? It's about Parker.
I'm not about to change my mind.